Hi, everybody. It's Pastor Perry here, and I've got a reading from Romans chapter 8, verse 28 for you today. It says, "We know that all things work together for good for those who love God, who are called according to his purpose." Sometimes this verse gets translated that all things are good and that God is taking everything in the world and using those things to make it good, or that he's making those things happen to bring good about. I don't think that God necessarily is bringing this coronavirus upon us, but I do think that God can use this time to bring good and to make good things happen in the world around us. And one of the things that I think God is using this time frame to do is to allow us to have a time of stillness and a time to know God and to be able to hear God better as he speaks to us. I think about how crazy busy the world had been prior to about a week ago, and how we're running all sorts of different places and have so many different events to go to and so many things to keep us busy. And now all of a sudden, those events are all canceled. Those things that we are busy with have come to a halt, and we are finding time to be still and to listen to the world around us and to listen to God's voice in our lives. This time also of self-distancing or quarantining is also giving us a time to connect with other people, to make phone calls, to send emails, to text them, to maybe rekindle some relationships that have maybe dwindled away, or that we haven't spoken to in a while, or people that we haven't spoken to in a while. Also, this time, I think, gives us an understanding of some of the things that we idolize in this world, that we are extremely focused on, and how we can now live without those, or how we adjust to life without some of the things that have kept us busy, and really to see how important we have made those things in our lives. I believe this also gives us a time to serve our neighbor. It gives us a reason to be looking out for our neighbor and to be asking them, "What is it that I can do for you? How can I help you?" And also it gives us a time to be united in prayer. As the whole world is really struggling with this pandemic, it gives us a time to really think about our neighbors, whether they're our neighbors in the house next to us, or whether they're the neighbors in our community, or whether they are the neighbors around the world. But this gives us a time to understand how big this community is and how we can reach out and love one another. And so it also gives us a time to pause and to be in prayer for this community. And so at this time, let us join together in prayer. Dear Jesus, we come to you today and we give you thanks for being able to bring out good in any situation, no matter how horrible it seems. And Lord, we pray that you would be with us today, and that you would be with us in this time frame, that you would use this time to bring good to us, to help us to build community, time to reconnect with those that we love, a time to be still and to listen to you, and a time to focus on our lives and to understand what is really important. Lord, I pray for all who are anxious today, all who are fearful. Pray that you would give to them a spirit of calmness and peace, and the ability to be patient and to be aware of those who are around them and the needs that they have. Lord, we thank you for your love. We thank you for your forgiveness. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.